Hi kids! Welcome to our online service that has been produced specially for you.
Hi Daniel! Do you remember what we've been learning about this December?
We've been learning about the people who played an important role in the birth of Jesus.
Yes, you're right. And do you know why we've been learning about them now?
Because it's the season of Christmas. And do you remember all the gifts I received?
You got so many gifts that cannot remember all of them anymore, but can you show me what you got for Christmas this year?
I got slime and paintbrushes and these paints and these canvas boards and all these books.
Oh my, so many wonderful gifts. Wait a minute. I've got something for you too. Hold on. Before you open it, I want you to guess what's inside.
Is it a new dress? Or those shoes I've been asking for ages?
No. Not even close. Let me give you a clue. This gift did not cost any money. It was a free gift.
You didn't pay any money for this gift? What kind of a gift is this? Is it a box of chocolates? Or candies?
No. Let me give you another clue. Once you get this gift, you have to share it with others. This gift is the reason for Christmas. This gift is the best gift in the world.
Oh, I can't wait to open this box and see what's inside.
Okay, you can open it.
Jesus? What kind of a gift is this? Jesus? What am I supposed to do with it? I'm sure you could have thought of something better.
Actually, Daniel, I thought about it a lot. And I realized Jesus is the best gift anyone could ever receive. This is just a piece of paper, but Jesus is the real deal. Jesus is God's gift to us. Jesus is the best gift because He is our healer, He is our protector, He is our savior. Jesus gave us the gift of eternal life. That is the best gift anyone could ever receive.
Wow, that's amazing. Now I can trade all the gifts I received for Jesus.
Yes, and now that we know that Jesus is the best gift, did you know that Jesus, when he was born, he got gifts also? Just like how you get gifts on your birthday.
Jesus got gifts? I wonder who gave him those gifts. And what gifts he received. And what gifts I can give Jesus.
Hold on. We learn all about that in today's lesson. But first, let's pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for being the perfect gift. Thank you that you gave us the gift of eternal life. We thank you that through today's lesson, you are going to show us more about you, and we are going to learn more about you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Chapter 2, verse 13. Then a very large group of angels from heaven joined the first angel. All the angels were praising God, saying, "Give glory to God in heaven and on earth. Let there be peace to the people who please God." When Jesus was born, angels appeared in the skies and started praising him, telling, "Glory to God." They were worshipping Jesus because he is God and King, because he are King and ruler of heaven and earth. Let us praise him and worship him just like the angels did, joyfully. Let us give our best voice, our best dance, and our best action for this King who loves us so much.
Merry Christmas!
We hope you had a wonderful Christmas. Did you have a good Christmas lunch? I'm sure you did. So today, we're going to be celebrating our King of Kings. You know, Jesus was born as a baby, but he was also a king. Let me read a verse for you from Matthew chapter 2, verse 2. Wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." You know, today we worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So let's take some time together, join in with us as we worship our King of Kings.
He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, he is the King.
Once again, he is
the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, he is the King.
Scale change.
He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, he is the King.
Okay, kids, now let's do something. Let's do a little bit of fill in the blanks. So when I say King of, you're going to fill in the blanks and say Kings. And when I say Lord of, you're going to fill in the blank and say Lords. Should we try that? Come on, let's sing that again.
He is the King of Kings.
He is the Lord
of Lords.
His name is
Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, he is the King.
Once again, he is the King of
Kings.
He is the Lord of
Lords.
His name is Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh,
King.
Hey, hey!
Even on that first Christmas, we see that shepherds came to worship him, wise men came to worship him, and the angels announced and worshipped the arrival of this King on the earth. Let's sing about this King.
A king is born this day in Bethlehem. Hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah.
No crown is worn, but angels worship him.
Hallelujah. Almighty God, so meek, so mild, salvation comes through this holy child.
A king is born.
He is in the manger now.
A king is born.
Hallelujah.
Shepherds bow down to see his holy face.
Hallelujah. Heaven is singing of peace on earth, filled with the wonder of his birth.
A king is born.
Humbly come and humbly bow.
A king is born.
Humbly come and humbly bow.
A tiny boy.
Reaching out his tiny hand.
A king is born this day
in Bethlehem. Come humbly.
Come humbly and humbly bow. He's in the manger now.
Come humbly and humbly bow. He's in the manger now.
Come humbly and humbly bow. He's in the manger now.
Come humbly and humbly bow. He's in the manger now.
A king is born this day in Bethlehem. Hallelujah.
Ooh, hallelujah.
No crown is worn by angels worship him.
Hallelujah. Almighty God, so meek, so mild, salvation comes through this holy child.
A king is born.
Everybody praise his name.
A king is born.
We will never be the same.
A tiny Lord
reached out his mighty hand.
A king is born this day.
A king is born, we will never be the same.
A king is born,
lift up his mighty hand.
A king is born this day in Bethlehem.
This day in Bethlehem. This day in Bethlehem.
King of Majesty,
I have one desire, just to be with you, my Lord. Just to be with you, my Lord. Jesus, you are the Savior of my soul. And forever and ever I give my praises to you. Jesus, you are the Savior of my soul. Praises to you. Jesus, you deserve all of our praise because you are our King of Kings and our Lord of Lords. Thank you for coming down to save us from sin and death and for giving us, Lord, a life that we can spend with you to eternity. We praise you, we worship you, we give you glory. And all of God's children said, Amen.
Hi everyone. Today we are going to go to Hannah's first birthday party. But I don't seem to find Chippy Lola anywhere and we're going to be late. I tell you, Chippy Lola, every time she's late.
Sorry, I was just finishing wrapping up the presents I got for Hannah.
Oh, that's nice. So what did you get for Hannah?
At the beginning, I was confused about what to give a one-year-old baby. But after I went shopping, I found a few nice gifts like a cute cuddly doll, a tiny dress. I also got her some colorful toys, some baby shampoo, and some baby powder as well.
Wow, that's very thoughtful, Chippy Lola. Don't you all think so, kids? And I'm sure Hannah will be very happy using all of those. Hey, talking about kids, and since we've just celebrated Christmas yesterday, did you know that when Jesus was a baby, he received gifts as well?
Really? I wonder who gave gifts to Jesus?
Now you're thinking. It was the three wise men who came to visit Jesus from far away. And they brought him gifts. But they did not give him the usual gifts that we give to babies. They gave him special gifts.
Special? What do you mean by special gifts?
They gave him gold, myrrh, and frankincense.
Yes, I remember this. I have always wondered why they gave that to a baby. What would a baby do with them?
Huh? Right question. But let me tell you a fun fact then. Each of those gifts symbolized aspects of Christ's life and ministry. The work that he would do. Do you know what they represent, Chippy Lola? The gift of gold that was given represented a gift that was given to the kings that showed that Christ is our King. The frankincense is a type of a perfume used for worship in the Jewish temple. It was worthy. And it is a worthy gift for Christ since he was the anointed one who deserves our worship. Now myrrh is a gum of a plant which was used during the burial of people. It was a prophetic gift because Jesus would die for the sins of the world.
Wow, that's very thoughtful. The gifts were basically given to Jesus to show Jesus as God, King, and man.
Wow, you seem to have understood a lot, Chippy Lola, and you can be the fourth wise man, maybe?
Welcome back, children. Let's see what our present is today. What is this? Sugar and milk? What kind of present is this? Cocoa powder and dark chocolate? Oh wait, these look like ingredients to make hot chocolate. Yay, I love this present. It's perfect for the weather and I can just picture myself spending time with my family and friends, sipping on hot chocolate and watching a movie. Oh, I have an idea. I can show you how to make it and then you can invite your friends over and make it for them. And then you can drink it and watch a nice movie about the real Christmas. Are you ready to make some hot chocolate? So you start by adding 120 grams of milk in a pan. To that you add 30 grams of cream. If you don't have cream, you can just add 150 grams of milk. And then to that you add a little bit of vanilla, 2 grams of cocoa powder and 2 grams of sugar. Now whisk until your cocoa powder dissolves. You heat up your mixture. And then add your chopped chocolate, 45 grams of dark chocolate. And keep whisking until all your chocolate melts. Once your chocolate is melted, your hot chocolate is ready to be served. So you can serve it to all your friends. You can even decorate it with marshmallows or whipped cream or sprinkles. You can even use chocolate chips or just your chocolate shavings. And that's it. Your hot chocolate is ready. All right, kids. Now that my hot chocolate is ready, it's time to watch a short movie on where the wise men came from and why did they even come searching for Jesus.
Far away to the east of Judea lived the wise men. They had seen a beautiful star shining over Bethlehem. They knew the star was a sign from God. They decided to follow it. They traveled all the way to Jerusalem on camels for many days, over mountains, over deserts, and over wide plains. But no matter what, they always followed the bright star in the sky. At that time, King Herod was ruling over the kingdom, and when he heard about a king being born, he was afraid that he would lose the kingdom. So he told the wise men, "Tell me when you find this child, so that I can honor him too." The wise men kept following the bright star, which finally stopped in Bethlehem. The wise men were overjoyed that the star led them in the right direction and they finally reached their destination. Then they saw baby Jesus and Mary. Knowing that Jesus was the Son of God, they all knelt down before him and worshipped him. They had come with a lot of valuable gifts too.
So we learned this from Chipilola children. Do you remember what gifts the wise men brought Jesus? Can you type your answers in the live chat? Yes, they gifted Jesus gold, frankincense and myrrh. The story is not yet over, children. Before we finish the story, let's see what we can learn from the wise men. They could have gotten distracted along the way, right, children? They could have got tired and returned home. Or they could have kept all the valuable gifts for themselves instead of bringing it to Jesus. Or instead of going to a small manger in Bethlehem, they could have gone to a nice city and enjoyed themselves. No, but they didn't do all that. They were focused on what God wanted them to do. Follow the star and reach Jesus.
Jeremiah 29:30. You will search for me, and when you search for me with all your heart, you will find me. Just like how the wise men were seeking Jesus, we should also seek him. We too can pursue Jesus in the midst of the holiday hustle and bustle by going to the Bible. This Christmas season and year round, let's dive into the scriptures like the wise men, seeing Christ's glory and finding him time and time again, witnessing to others along the way. So let's stand up, hold your Bibles high up in the air, and make a declaration. Say this out loud, bold and strong with me. This is God's word. This is God speaking to me. I am who God says I am. I can do what God says I can do. I will become everything God has promised. I am saved, healed, delivered, redeemed. I am blessed, victorious, prosperous, and triumphant. I am a minister of God, a servant of Christ, and a channel of His blessing to many people. I receive His word, I believe His word, and I live by His word. Christ is my master. To Him, I am in absolute surrender. I walk into the more glorious covenant with God. I live the more glorious life in the Spirit. I manifest the more glorious ministry in the Spirit. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Welcome back, children. The last few weeks, we learned about the different characters in the nativity scene. Remember? We learned about Elizabeth, Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds. Today, we heard a little bit about the wise men who followed a star to get to baby Jesus. Do you want to know more about them? I'll tell you. I'm sure all of you are wondering what happened after the wise men reached Bethlehem and offered their gifts to baby Jesus. Did they go back to King Herod to let him know where to find the baby? Let's see.
They left Bethlehem and they went back home another road. Remember, children? King Herod instructed them to come back to him and tell him where the baby was, but they did not go back to him. You know why, children? Because they all had a dream. In that dream, they were warned not to go back and tell King Herod where they found Jesus. King Herod did not want to find Jesus to worship him. Instead, he wanted to kill him because he was jealous of this baby that he would someday take his place as king. So the wise men traveled back to their homes by another road. And after the wise men had gone, an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, hurry, take the child and his mother to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is looking for the child and he wants to kill him. That very night, Mary and Joseph, along with Jesus, left for Egypt and they lived there. Later, when Herod died, an angel came to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up and take the child and his mother and come back to Israel." King Herod, who wanted to kill the baby, is now dead. Soon, they shifted back to Bethlehem in Israel, and that was the place where Jesus grew up.
Such an adventurous story, right, children? What do you learn from these wise men? For the wise men, nothing could stop them from worshipping the King Jesus. They did not let anything get in their way to divert their attention from their mission to worship King Jesus. Children, we too have so many things to distract us when we want to worship Jesus. If we are not careful, especially during this Christmas season when there is so much happening, decorations, cakes, vacation, new clothes and gifts, all these are good things and help give the Christmas season a boost of energy and fun. But the enemy, Satan, wants to fill our lives with materialistic things, so we forget the real meaning of Christmas and we shift our focus away from the King of Kings. Children, this Christmas season, let us focus our attention on Jesus. Jesus was born to give us his life, so that our sins will be forgiven and we can go to heaven. He is our best gift. So what can we give him, children? These are the three gifts we can give Jesus, children, and show that we worship him. Let's open them up one by one now. Are you ready? Here comes the first box. I wonder what's in the box. Oh, love. Yes, children, we should love Jesus and love others. This Christmas season, you can show your love by helping someone in need. You could give a toy to a poor child or buy something nice for a poor family or a friend. You could also show your love to others by sharing things you like. Maybe sharing a toy with your sibling or sharing your favorite chocolate with your parents or friends. You can also show love by giving a big hug to your grandparents or any of your family members. Let's see what's in the next box. Here comes the second box. What's in it? Oh, it's repentance, children. The Bible always teaches that we need to repent of our sins. So think of a time you have sinned or done something wrong. Maybe you have been speaking rudely to your parents or disobeyed them by not doing your chores. Maybe you lied about something. Or if you were selfish and did not share anything with your friends. Maybe you spent more time watching TV without reading the Bible. All this can be a sin, children. Just confess your sin to Jesus and he will make you clean and do not repeat them going forward. Let's open the last box now. Are you ready, children? This one has the gift of obedience. Children, do you want to please God? Then obeying him is the best thing to do. We can obey him by reading the Bible and praying to him. The most important form of obedience is that we have to share the gospel to everyone, children. So when we share the gospel of how Jesus is our Savior with our friends and family, we are telling them the true meaning of Christmas. Let's focus on Jesus and bring our best gifts to him.
hanging all the lights on the main street square. People are smiling everywhere. Trees up in the windows, frost on the glass. Christmas is here now, here at last. But let's not forget, in the middle of the busyness, remember this, Jesus is the reason for this time of the year. We're gonna celebrate, it's Christmas. Oh, let me hear that joyful noise in the air. Wanna hear it everywhere. Heaven and earth proclaim, come on, let's celebrate, it's Christmas. Pull out your favorite records, some Nat King Cole. Movies that never get old. Gather up the family, carol the town. People need love, so spread it around. And let's not forget, it's what you give, not what you get. Remember this, Jesus is the reason for.
Enjoyed the online service today. We would love to hear from you. Tell us what you think. Either you may leave your comments in the live chat below, or you may send an email to kidsonline@apcwo.org. Before we close, is there anyone who's celebrating your birthday today? Why don't you go ahead, write your name, your birth date and age in the live chat. We as a team would love to wish you as well as pray for you. We look forward to hearing from you. Before we close, let's close our eyes in prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for this beautiful day, Lord. And we thank you for this online service that we attended today. Lord, thank you so much, Lord, for teaching us, Master, your word. Lord, help us to remember what we have learned today, not just today, Master, but throughout this week, Lord. Help us to remind ourselves of what we have been taught. Lord Jesus, even as we enter this last week of the year, Lord, we want to remember all the good things that you have done to us throughout this year, Master. And even as we enter the new year, help us to take some fresh commitments and enter into this new year with the main purpose of growing more closer to you, Lord Jesus. Lord, we want to surrender everything that concerns us into your precious hands. Let your presence lead us, guide us, and protect us throughout this week, Master. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Bye-bye, everybody. I'll see you all next time.
Bye, children. I'll see you next Sunday.